Dr. Watson, would you kindly close the door behind you so that we can limit the price of your carelessness to merely hours of work rather than days?
My apologies, Mr. Holmes. I found myself rather taken aback. I saw tidier houses in war-torn Afghanistan. Are those my surgical needles?
I ran out of tacks and the matter required immediate attention.
Was that my supper?
Plainly not, for I was the one who ate it.
I set it aside for this evening.
And for that, I am grateful.
Is that my bed?
Watson, since you've proven yourself a master of observation, might I ask you to apply your skills to a more pertinent question? Namely, the whereabouts of today's newspapers. They are the key to everything. The newsboy is usually reliable.
Medically speaking, I often find that the key to everything is good sleep. In a bed. Your papers are here, on the table.
Let us see what the postman brought today.
This mess is getting out of hand. What will the landlady think?
Your order from Barnes' bookshop has arrived, Doctor.
Barnes insists on delivering the books to our door, even though we could easily walk to his shop. That's good service.
Another letter from Werner. I never reply, but they keep coming. Local gossip, all of it uninteresting. I don't see the Strand. Where is it?
Pardon me?
I am on the precipice of uncovering a pattern of crime across London spanning many months and involving many men. The missing paper cannot be a coincidence.
That's preposterous.
My dear fellow, life is infinitely stranger than anything which the mind of man can invent.
Well, life used your newspaper to wipe its posterior, so after that unpleasant discovery this morning, I disposed of it. But in lieu of the Strand, perhaps I can deliver you something equally tantalizing. I have just returned from a patient of mine, Captain Stemwick, who...
No, no, that will not do. Grab your coat, Dr. Watson. Let us hope nobody has collected the dustbin. You were mistaken, Dr. Watson. The paper was indeed dirtied, but not how you implied. It's potting soil. Cactus spine. If it gets in your skin, it's awfully tricky to remove, and when laced with poison, the perfect assassination tool. See, Watson? The conspiracy is real. Someone tried to poison me.
Poison? You? That's madness. Do you even have enemies that would want to kill you? Okay, perhaps from Cordona.